Welcome, welcome to the seventh day of our 21 Days of Energy Challenge. If you're just joining us, my name is Rachel from Reiki with Rachel. You can find out more about me on my website, ReikiWithRachel.com. I also encourage you to follow me on Instagram so you can get the daily card messages and just different energy-infused fun stuff. So, what we've been doing, again, if you are new, is I am talking about the daily energy as we're really acclimating to these changes that fall is bringing. This is a huge time of change, of positive change, but it can have ups and downs, as any process does, as any journey does. So we're going over the daily energy and pulling oracle cards from James Rand Prague's The Soul's Journey oracle card deck, just kind of talking about what the energies are saying, and then we do a 5-minute energy healing session at the end. So today's card is self-esteem. I'll show it to you. There you go. And the card I pulled came upside down. And so with oracle cards and angel cards, often this means that there's an emphasis on it. So it doesn't mean that it's the reverse of it. It just means that it's of extra importance. So it kind of makes sense that as we're finishing this first week, we were given a card that the energy is indicating, like, you really need to pay attention to this. Okay, we've worked on stuff this week, we're cleansing out the energy. It's time now that you focus on your self-esteem. And by self-esteem, the way I really interpret this is your worthiness. And I'll read the card to you. It says, I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. This card is really emphasizing to us this week that you have unique and individual gifts that, because of doubt and fear and maybe not knowing what to do or how to go about it, or, you know, just some blockages, some old maybe karmic patterns or subconscious beliefs, like, we have all this stuff that's stopping us. But once we can push through this, once we can understand that we are so worthy, if we have a desire, that's coming from somewhere. That is coming from our higher selves, from our soul's calling. You can't ignore it, but sometimes we'll push it off, or we'll try to step into it, but it's kind of like whenever you're getting into a really cold pool and you like dip your toe in, you're like, oh, no, I don't know. And maybe you take a step down and you hang out there for a little while and you're like, oh, I don't know if I want to get in the pool, it's cold and I don't know how it's going to be. And it's kind of like that. And it's time to just jump in. It's time to recognize that you are worthy, that whatever you have been divinely guided to do, and you absolutely have been getting divine guidance, don't push it away. Don't allow doubt or just negative energy patterns that we've gotten into. Don't allow those to push it away, to say, that's cool, but I don't even know how I do it. You have to step into your worthiness, to your deserving, your feelings of deserving, because you deserve to live this life that you want. You deserve it just as much as anybody else does. This spiritual journey is not easy, and I'm assuming we're on it. If you're watching this video, you're on some sort of spiritual journey. It's not easy. It's full of obstacles, but I think I mentioned this in a previous video. Sometimes we get so used to these obstacles blocking us, we just kind of accept it, and we don't allow ourselves to step into the good, because in the back of our mind, subconsciously, we have that thought, like, it's not going to work out anyway. It hasn't in the past, so it's not going to this time. Today is a day that you state to yourself over and over and over again, I love myself and I am worthy of blank. Anytime a doubt comes up, I love myself and I am worthy of love, of abundance, of success, of living my dreams, of bringing my gifts to the world. You are worthy. Don't hold yourself back. That's why this card came upside down. It is emphasizing this because it knows that we need to hear it right now. It knows that it's necessary that we jump, because if we don't do it now, you always get a second chance. I'm not trying to scare you, but if you don't step into your worthiness now, you're just gonna fall back into old patterns. The first week is now complete of this energy challenge. The first week of fall is now complete. Step into your worthiness. And I'm so excited to see what the next 2 weeks bring. It's going to be pretty powerful, I think. But we need to step into this worthiness first. So let's focus on that for this energy healing. Let's focus on you just knowing that you deserve everything you desire, that your soul is calling and you have the power to follow that soul's calling. You have the power to make things happen. Don't doubt yourself. So if you have any specific intentions that you want to set for this energy healing, I encourage you to set them now. But we're really going to send it for this worthiness. And what I'm going to do is the first half of this, after I connect with your energy, I'm going to send energy to flush out the blocks to your worthiness. And then for the second half, I'm going to send energy to really build you up. That energy to just wrap around your spirit and your soul and grow that light that is within you. So all you have to do is find a comfortable spot. I'm going to connect with your energy now. Do the sacred symbols. Then we're gonna do a little flushing out of the old and revitalizing what's always been there, but may have been lying dormant. Okay, let's get started. Thank you. energy field or auric field, anything that doesn't serve you, wiping mine off. Disconnecting from the energy, so be it, and so it is. Thank you so much. I don't know if y'all felt that. There was some powerful stuff going on there. There was a shift. There was a shift. So, I hope you enjoyed it. Okay. So yeah, week one is complete. I will see you tomorrow for the beginning of our second week of our energy challenge. Thank you so much. I'll see you tomorrow. Namaste.